The report was released by the Directorate of Ethics and Integrity during a meeting with different stakeholders from the Renzori region in Fort Portal. The meeting sought to assess the extent of how the country is implementing the zero tolerance to corruption policy and evaluate the progress made so far in fighting it.
So even if a government official is not giving a bribe, we find our citizens offering us bribe. And the temptation is so great that sometimes some of us will not refuse to take it. So we need now to intensify mindset change.
Nicholas Abola, the commissioner in charge of communication and information at the Directorate of Ethics and Integrity, stated that the results of this report are deeply concerning.
The public have lost trust in service delivery. Let me not say corruption, but in service delivery. And the reason why they have lost trust is because corruption has eaten every aspect of service delivery. You go to health, to education, security, everywhere there's corruption.
The report attributes this erosion of trust to a combination of factors, including inefficiency and a lack of transparency in service delivery mechanisms.
Are we going to fight the corruption to zero? There was the whole thing was where? We don't have solutions. The whole room was where? Nobody was answering. It means this thing is very, very hard. It only requires partial mindset.
The economic demands of this country. When you look at the discrepancy of the salaries, it's also causing corruption. Because the person is getting 28 million, when another one is getting 200,000.
The report pointed out cases of bribery, nepotism, and other forms of corruption to be the greatest factors hindering fair access to public services.
So that government loses almost to a tune of 9 trillion in a year. Now 9 trillion, if this was your personal money, you have lost in a business person, 9 trillion is lost. That means that the business is going to collapse. So we are always thinking that if we don't do something about corruption now, our economy may collapse.
Law enforcement agencies also came under scrutiny with allegations of corruption, abuse of power, and a lack of transparency leading to a decline in trust.
Government injects a lot of money in these circles and the cooperative societies. And we have commercial officers at this level. But these internal auditors and the external auditors don't always audit these cooperative societies.
If you are there having that small amount of salary and someone gives you a push to get some more money, will you really stop from getting that?
The report from the Directorate of Ethics also recommends implementing robust anti-corruption measures by having anti-corruption court sessions at the regional level, enhancing transparency in service delivery, and improving the overall efficiency of government agencies.
Instead of saying decentralizing, we can say, can we have sessions, anti-corruption court sessions, to be brought up country? It could be at the regional level.
Report by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.